What is up? What it do? So this is the stats from the season. T-Jack, you know, he handled his business, but he still threw 12 picks. Chris Johnson had 24 TDs on the ground, adding another 7 in the pass game. So that's 31 total TDs. He ties LT, the guy who he replaced this year. He ties LT's single season record for most total touchdowns in a game. Or not a game, excuse me, a season. My fault, y'all. But yeah, no, we have some pretty solid numbers. We had a lot of receivers, 600 plus yards. We liked airing it out. You know, our tackles weren't as high, but I think it's because our defense wasn't on the field as long. Sacks, we were decent. No one double digits. INTs, we were eating up. We had a safety by Beason and then Beason and Houston, respectively, with defensive touchdowns. Rob Baronis, he did not miss all year. He hit like 3 or 4 times from over 60. Go back and watch season 4. T-Jack was the best quarterback in the league. In terms of interception, these are the guys who had single digits. And Drew Brees threw the most with 23. Bullock, 22. Trent Edwards, 22. We had a lot off those three guys. Remember, we literally ripped to Trent Edwards a new one when we played him. Chris Johnson looks like he's 10th in the league for rush yards. This is who follows him. And he's got the by far the most touchdowns in the league. He's on a 4.8 average, too. That's pretty impressive. Chad Johnson, a.k.a. Ocho Cinco, has the most catches in the league. However, when it comes to receiving yards, Randy Moss takes the cake in that one. And Randy Moss, if you can see it, and I don't think we pull it up. I'm not sure. But he has the most receiving touchdowns, too. You can see Nate Burleson is cracking the top 20 for receiving yards himself. So, yeah, we're solid, man. Nick Barnett ate up, though. He had over 200 tackles in one season, which is crazy. And here's the sack leaders from this year. INT leaders, Champ, Ty Hill, and Mike Huff are tied. And when it comes to kicking, we were the only ones that went perfect when it came to kicking. Martin Gramatica, I don't count because he got cut after a game or two. But yeah, those are the stats. And look at who we pulled in the divisional round. We pulled the Denver Broncos, who finished the regular season 8-8. The Titans snuck into the playoffs, lost to Miami. The Giants lost to the Bucks. The Broncos handled business with the Chargers, the division rival. And the Packers fell to the 49ers. So we'll have a new host out of the NFC for the Super Bowl. Now, who knows if we'll be able to play them, because we still have to get there. And I'm not going to jinx anything. This is how we stack up to Denver. Looking pretty solid. And here we'll take a look at how their roster has evolved over years. And you guys know it's very personal when we play Denver in the playoffs. So we got to handle our business. They got Lendale White and Kevin Jones, their running backs. Westbrook left in free agency. Chad Johnson, Reggie Williams, and Drew Bennett are still there. They don't have Kellen Winslow anymore, but it looks like they drafted a new tight end to replace him. They still have a solid offensive line. So, looking good there. Brayton is still the end. John Abraham and Jarvis Green. They did bring in John Abraham this year. That was new. I can't remember if John Henderson was here or not. Boss Bailey, that's Champ's little brother. Tavares Gooden, he was on our roster the first couple seasons. Unfortunately, Ray Lewis is out for the year. He has an injury, which I'm surprised they can even keep him on the sideline. You know, that dude is a competitor. But yeah, Brian Williams is a Pro Bowl corner. And it's funny, out of the 4 Pro Bowl cornerbacks in the AFC, 3 of them are from our team, and Brian Williams is the 4th. I'm sure you can assume which 3. I thought we were going to sweep it because we had Chris Houston too, but unfortunately we didn't sweep it. But anyway, to the game now. We got to handle our business. CJ2K with a gain to start off the game. So there we go. First down and 10. Chris Johnson trying to get it outside. That's not going to work. Brian Williams comes up and makes the play. Second and 9. Chris Johnson spinning, but it's not going anywhere. Third down now for the Colts. Tavares Jackson finds Nate Burleson on the out, and Nate Burleson's inside the 40, muscles his way to the 35-yard line. First down and 10 now. Tavares Jackson drops back. Under pressure, that's going to be ruled an incompletion. Second down and 10, Jackson dropping back again. Going to roll to his right, looking for somebody to throw to. No one's really open, and that one he threw away. Luckily, he was out of the pocket, so no intentional grounding. Third down now, Jackson, he's going to run with it. Breaks the tackle, but oh, the guy knocks the ball out of his hands. Williams forced the fumble as he was going down, just punched it right out, you could see. And Denver recovers, so they get the ball back. First down, he throws it into the dirt. Second down, DeLome looking. dumps it to Martin. Third down and six now for Denver. Delhomme looking, taking a shot on the corner route, and that's going to be brought in by Drew Bennett. So the Broncos are driving. First down, hand off to Lendale White. Runs over Rhodes, runs through Poole's tackle. Not Poole, my fault. Champ Bailey is going to bring him down inside the 10. And yeah, right there, Lendale White goes nowhere. Great play by Thomas Howard. Second down, that's play made by Thomas Howard once again. Third down, they find Drew Bennett, but that was third down. So, yeah, you came up short. Fourth and goal, they send the kicker. Kick is up. Kick is good. So the Broncos are on the board first. And they get the ball to start the second half. So not looking good. Right there, looking for Burleson. That's knocked away. Second down and 10. Tavares Jackson hands off to Chris Johnson. CJ2K spin move, and he gets tackled, but he's out to almost the 40-yard line. First down, Jackson looking, taking a shot deep to Antonio Gates. Great awareness, great body control to make that catch. Unbelievable. First down, Chris Johnson, he's going to get a few. Takes a hit from the defensive tackle. Second down, Jackson looking, finds Nate Burleson. Nate Burleson breaks two tackles on that play, and he's inside the 5-yard line. First and goal, Chris Johnson bounces it outside. He's in the end zone. Touchdown, Colts. So we take the lead. Lendale White trying to get outside. That's going nowhere. Great play. Second down and 11. Handoff is to White again. That's going nowhere. Third down and 10 now for the Broncos. Delhomme dumps it to Martin. That's not going to get anywhere near the first down. Brings up fourth down. First down and 10 play action. Tavares Jackson taking a shot deep to Randy Moss. And it's picked off by Rucker, the strong safety. I couldn't remember what safety he was. I can't even talk. That was terrible. That was terrible commentating. Excuse me. So, Jake Delhomme on first down. Delhomme looking. And, yeah, Reggie Williams breaking a couple tackles. He picks up the first down. Crazy. And Champ Bailey's hurt. Great. Great, great, great. First down and 10. Jake Delhomme. That pass is going to be incomplete. Beeson came off clean on the blitz and got a hit on Delhomme to alter the throw. Right there, that pass complete is the mark. Oh, I can't talk. I'm tripping over my words. I'm so sorry, guys. I am so sorry. Please don't hold this against me. But right there, Reggie Williams, the hit knocks the ball loose. So it brings up fourth down. The field goal, the kick is up. The kick is good. Champ Bailey, pinched nerve. He's going to be out of quarter. Right there. Chris Johnson trying to get something going. He can't. I'm trying to get something going in this commentating. It's not working. Right there, Tavares Jackson is sacked. Third and long. Jackson. Taking a shot deep to the other Jackson. Deshaun brings it in, and that is a first down for the Colts. Stretch play to Chris Johnson. He gets the outside. Chris Johnson inside the 10, inside the 5. Makes a man miss. He's down to about the 2-yard line. First and goal, Chris Johnson bounces it out. Touchdown, CJ2K. So there we go. We are now up 14-6. Delhomme looking. Pump fakes. Slings it over to Ocho Cinco, but that is dropped by Darrell Revis. Should have been a pick. Second down, Lendale White, trying to make something happen. Gets a few yards on that carry, but they're going to get Jackson the center for clipping, and that's going to be brought back to, I don't know what yard line, but it's second and 19. And that pass is incomplete. Third and long, Delhomme looking, has a lot of time. Julius Peppers gets back there. Delhomme avoids him. That was his teammate in Carolina in reality, and that's going to be a complete. They were looking for Chad Johnson, a.k.a. Ocho Cinco. I don't know which one y'all want me to call him, but I'll probably call him Ocho Cinco because that's what he wants to call himself. Even though I can say I'm taking Spanish in school, that is 8-5, not 85. Right there, that, again, great awareness, great body control by Antonio Gates to make that catch. Great run by Chris Johnson right there, making the safety miss. And great run that he just had, and great run here. So three great runs by Chris Johnson after the great catch by Gates. And yeah, 21-6. The Broncos trying to get something going. Reggie Williams, he can break the tackle, but he can't bring the catch in. Kind of odd. Second down. Williams, he brings that catch in, though, this time. And the Broncos have to burn a timeout. Third and 7. Delhomme looking. And, yeah, Martin's going to bring that corner in. And Martin's loose. The 20. He's inside the 10 before Rhodes can finally bring him down. So first and goal for Denver. They're in striking distance. Looking, and that's tipped and picked off by Kerry Rhodes. So we make a big stand in the red zone. First down, play action. Tavares Jackson rolling to his right. Finds Mark Clayton crossing the field. Mark Clayton's out to about the 30-yard line. So we run no huddle. And we're running the same exact play. Look. And Tavares Jackson's looking. He's taking a shot deep. That's Deshaun Jackson. at a cow, and that's a touchdown for DeSean Jackson. So we get that, and now the Broncos are coming back. That's incomplete. And this is the start of the second half, by the way. DeLome, that's incomplete too. Poole coming from the free safety spot off the edge. Right there, Ed Reed applying pressure. That's incomplete, so we get the ball back. First down, Chris Johnson. Second down and six, play action. Jackson looking. Looking for Gates again. On that play for the third time, that time the linebacker can't stick with him, and that's a touchdown. Putting a strong safety on him, fine. Put a linebacker on him, you're done, like he was just there. Right there, they're going to find Ocho Cinco. He's going to break Revis' tackle, but Rhodes puts him in the ground. Right here, DeLome looking. Taking a shot down the left side of the field. Reggie Williams, great catch on the play. And then he's brought down. First down, DeLome. He's going down. Julius Peppers with the sack. Second down and 14. DeLome drops back. Looking. Wide open is Reggie Williams. Man, they got us in the cover two. Yeah, everybody knows a corner route on cover two is killer. And they got us. So that's a nice touchdown. Right there, that was a nice hold by Vernon Davis. So even though Chris Johnson had a nice run, it's going to come back. Told you. Saw it. Everyone saw it. It was blatant. So, they have to call that. First down, Johnson. He's going to try to get some of that yardage back. Got six of those yards back. Second down, Tavares Jackson rolling to his right. Looking for Gates. That's incomplete. Looking in hindsight, probably should have floated it over the defense to Moss. Right here, Tavares Jackson is going to take off with it himself. He can't break that tackle. He's going to be about a yard or two short of the first. So we had the punt back to Denver. Play action now. Jake DeLome looking. Taking a shot to his man. Reggie Williams brings in a great catch, but he only had 1 foot in, unfortunately. So, yeah, sucks for them. Right there, Ocho Cinco makes the catch. Rhodes should have gave him a hit stick, but Ocho Cinco was just fast enough to get out of there before it happened. Right here, they're going to find Drew Bennett. That's going to be a first down for Denver. Move those chains. First down for Denver. DeLome drops back. He's getting sacked again. It looks like it's Julius Peppers once again. Right here, DeLome is looking. Finds Lendale White. On the screen, Lendale White tries to bounce it outside. Revis makes a nice tackle before he can break loose. Third down, DeLome drops back, pump fakes, and he is sacked yet again by Julius Peppers. So that is going to bring up fourth down, and we get the ball back. Counterplay to Chris Johnson, running to the left, breaks a tackle, gets about 8 or 9 on that run. Second and one, Chris Johnson again, spin move. He's out across the first down marker, and he's hurt. So he's a little banged up. Hopefully it is not bad because we already have our starting running back initially going into the season. He's out for the year. DeSean Jackson, that was a very nice catch and run right there. Now we got Rashard Mendenhall taking over starting running back duties temporarily, hopefully. Second down, Tavares Jackson finds DeSean Jackson on the dig, who's down to about the 5-yard line. DeSean Jackson really showing out against Denver this game. First down, Rashard Mendenhall getting a couple yards. Second and goal. Handoff is to Mendenhall again. He bounces it outside, and Rashard Mendenhall has his first touchdown in the playoffs, I believe. Right here, DeLome. Pump fakes. Looking. Rhodes, man. Rhodes missed the play, but Ocho Cinco can't catch on that play. So he's not going to be talking trash after that. Reggie Williams getting very close to that first down marker, and they gave him a very generous spot. DeLome on first down. He's going to find Chad Johnson, a.k.a. Ocho Cinco. Second down and 5. DeLome. Looking, floating the ball over to the left. That's tipped and picked off by Champ Bailey. And Champ Bailey's running out across the 50. He's tackled around the 46-yard line. And DRC is hurt. He hurt his hip. It doesn't show it, but it's a 2-week injury. He is going to miss the AFC Championship, presuming we keep this lead. Right there was a run by Jamal Charles and a field goal by Baronas. The kick is up, kick is good. Denver, they're down by 30-something, but they're going to try to make something happen. Looking for Ocho Cinco. That was a bad throw. DeLome looking again. Finds Bennett. That's going to bring up fourth down. And they just decided to punt. They gave up. So that's the end of the game. We get Denver in the playoffs. So feeling great about that. But yeah, solid game. Like I said, Dominique Rodgers-Cromartie's out next week. The AFC Championship game. I'm not going to say who we're playing against. But he's going to be out that game, unfortunately. So we're going to have to do without DRC. So hopefully Chris Houston will hold it down in that nickel spot. Jamal Charles getting a little bit of action. DeSean Jackson really came to play. Antonio Gates too. I mean, they were keying on Randy Moss, but it's all good. You're going to key on somebody, somebody else is going to step up and play. It's all good. But yeah, the Broncos, I mean, they're not the same team we played a couple years ago, man. And we're not the same team. We're better. We're potent. Julius Peppers bringing in those three sacks. Bailey and Rhodes with the picks. So we're going to move on to this AFC Championship game. Like I said, this could be the last dance, so let's try to bring it home.